said the hallway, as a kid in high school, I thought, love will save me. At this end of the hallway, I thought, if it doesn't, there's got to be a way out of here. Because I spent the better part of every day in high school running away from words. I was speaking at a synagogue nearby, I think it's in Coral Gables, to middle school students, age students. It was on bullying, kindness, character, stuff like that. And I guess one of the kids told the mother, and the mother told another parent who is now members or president of the PTA here, and they checked me out and said, we want to do something similar for our school. So it was really the PTA that got involved and wanted, your PTA, that really wanted to make this school a place of tremendous kindness and bring something like me to it. So I got into motivational speaking as a volunteer. I started out in 1992. I was living with HIV for 5 years at the time when I got infected in 87. And I thought, I have a few years left to live. I'll just volunteer and give my messages, my wisdom, my love, whatever I've got to offer, my time.
Yeah.
To students who will listen, anybody who will listen. And I started out in New York, where I live, and word got out.
Yeah.
And I started getting requests to speak in Wisconsin, and then I remember the day I got a phone call from Harvard and Yale School, both schools, on the same day, and I thought, okay, I think I have a new career here. So the message that I wanted to most, I mostly want you to leave this message. It's actually on the back of the shirt. It says, hashtag enough, that you are enough, that you have everything you need, right? That you don't have to be or do anything other than who you actually already are.